Now it says 5 musical bell ring at 3, 6, 9, 15, and 12 and 15 seconds. How many minutes to ring together 10 times? Do you know what the question wants?
LCM.
Huh? So LCM. Do you agree it's LCM? Okay, now let's try to understand LCM. Huh? Now LCM of these 5 numbers is what? Huh? 20. Yeah? 180. 120. So which one is the LCM? 180. Yeah? Do you know how to find LCM? 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Divide by what? 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can I stop here? Cannot. What must I do? Divide by 2. So this will be 1, 1, 3, 2, 5. Now, why is it 1, 1? 1, 1, 1. 2 divided by 2 is 1, right? 2, 4 divided by 2 is 2, right? So up to here, I can do two methods. One is I continue here by 2, continue by 3, continue by 5. Another way is I can say, oh, since there's no common number already, I can say this is the LCM. So what I do is LCM equals to 2, I have 2 of them. So this is 2 squared times 3 squared times 5. And what's the answer? 180, yeah, 180. Now, but before that, we need to understand what does 180 means. 180 means? Oh, okay, 180 means second. Now, 180 means after, so you want to write down, huh? This is just for understanding, not part of the presentation of answer. After 180 seconds, the 5 bell ring together or separately? Together. Now, I want it to ring 10 times together. So what is the answer? 180 times 10 equals 1800 seconds. Yeah, so I want to know how many minutes does it take. So what you do, you take 1800 divided by 60 and that will be 30. So 30 minutes. Next, question 4. Now question 4 says, regular. Can you explain to me what does regular means? All sides are equal. All angles are equal. Okay, let's continue. Interior angle, exterior angle. Now, let's start with a simple one. This is called what shape? Triangle. This is called what angle? Interior. This is called what angle? Exterior. Correct? Wow. Huh? What is wrong? Oh, exterior is not this, huh? Exterior is not this. So I reverse 2 times. I reverse. Exterior is actually if I extend a straight line. This is my exterior. Can follow so far? Can. Now, what's the characteristics if I add an interior plus exterior? Equals to 180. So interior plus exterior equals 180. So that's fact number one. Fact number two. Sum of all interior angle. What is the formula? Sum all exterior angle. 360 times n. Correct? Correct? Sum of all, sum of all. All. Equals to what? 360 or 360n? Let's try, let's try. Now, how to try? Simple. This angle is 50. What is the outside angle? Tell me. 130. Let's try another one. This angle is 70. What is outside? 110. Last angle is what? I draw wrongly. You know why wrong? Before I erase, the exterior angle must always be in the same direction. So this is wrong. I show you the correct one. This is correct. Can you follow? But never mind, never mind. The exam won't ask you. Isn't it the same? No. If you draw it the other way, you add up, it won't be 100. It will be lah, but it just looks wrong. That is another topic altogether. There's an application that string this, then the three angle will meet together to form that one loop. But that's another chapter altogether. Now third one, if this is 70, this is 50, what is this? 60. 60. And what is this? Here. This is 100 and 20. You try and add these three numbers together, what do you get? 360. So is there an N? No, there's no N. So the answer is this. Now why are you confused with N? Because sometimes you divide by N to find that one exterior angle. Now I give you three concepts. Number two, number three. These are the three concepts you need to know in angles. With these three concepts, can you solve the question? Those who ask me this question, can you now solve? Able to solve? What did you say? The interior is thrice. Thrice means? Three times. So, if this is not 50, if this is x, then this will be how many x? 3x. So then you just write off 3x plus x equals 180. So easy, right? So easy. Then you find an x, huh? Okay, next. Question 5?
No, don't know.
Whoa, okay. Now, box and whisker. Let's start. This is question 5, huh? Now, box and whisker, first, we want to know how it looks like. For your information, this will not come out. Now, now the trend is they will show you the graph, ask you to interpret. Instead of give you this, ask you to draw. But let's try. Can you all draw this randomly? Come, do with me. Randomly. Tell me X1 is what? On the space below. Don't draw on the graph. Draw the space below. Let's do this exercise together. Wei Xian, are you still with me? Are you doing? No. Oh. Oh, correct. No, you do lah. Correct. You correct, huh? Oh, okay. Sorry. Now, X1 is equals to what?
Minimum.
10, huh? 10 is the answer, but minimum. X2? Lower quartile. 25 percentile, right? 25 percentile. X3?
Median.
Median is also known as the 50th percentile. X4? UQ? X5? Upper quartile. 75 percentile. X5? Maximum. Now, answer the question. If I want to find range, what do I do? X what?
X5 minus?
X1. I want to find interquartile range. What do I do?
X4 minus? X2.
Now, you can answer this question, but you don't know how to draw because you don't know how to read discrete data, is it? Let's try discrete data. I can continue from here? Okay, let's start. Help me write a few numbers. Follow my number. 10, 12, 12, 13, 14, 16, 16, 17, 18, 20. How many numbers do I have? You like 10? Or you want one more? Okay, we start with 10, I'll start with 10. Okay. Now, say for example I want 10. How do I calculate median? What must I do?
Find the median number.
What's the median number of these 10 numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 6, right? So can you help me? You also copy this number on your paper, so we do together. So can you help me underline these two? And then point to the bottom and then tell me what is the median. 15, right? Now, if I have 15, did I use, my question, did I use 14 or 16? I did that. So, how to find lower quartile? You draw a box. I will box up, I will use 14 as well. Look at how many numbers do I have in the first box? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where's the middle? 12. So this is the lower quartile. Next one. I use another color. Box up another one. How many numbers do I have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where's the upper quartile? 17. This is the upper quartile. Clear? Do I know the minimum? 10. Do I know the maximum? 20. Okay. Now, next, I want you to draw the same thing. Draw the same thing. But, should we add one more number or should we erase one number? No answer. Should I add one more number or should I reduce one number? Reduce, okay, reduce. So we copy lesser number. Can you help me reduce 10? So you now you copy this number down. Make sure you have 9 items. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let me beautify it. Let me know when I can continue. Can I continue? Okay, quickly, quickly, write down the 9 numbers. I want to show you what if I have even number of item. On top is even number. This is even. E-V-E-N. Below, I have odd. Odd, discrete, is a different calculation. Let's start. I remove the circle, circle, circle so that you're not confused. I'm lazy to be right. Yay, we are done. Okay, let's start. I've got 9 numbers. Which one is the median? This is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the median? So this is median. Did I select this number? I did, right? I did select. So if I select this number, the box I draw cannot include 16 anymore. Cannot. So the first box will be just this 4 number. Instead of the top I include 14 because the median I didn't use the number. But here I use 16 as number. So the box now reduced to only 4 numbers. Where's the Q1?
12
plus 13. These 2 plus together divided by 2. So 12.5. Next one. This is the box. Again the median, the center of these 2. 17.5. This is the lower quartile, this is the upper quartile. Can I stop here? Are you able to do question 5? Those who are not sure just now? Can, good. Let's go. Yeah, I need to respond, I cannot be talking alone. So you tell me yes, no, then I know whether you are okay or not. Question 6, okay? Okay, thank you. 7? Thank you. 8?
Oh,
8, no. Okay, 8. Come, let's just do it together. This is an old school question. Old school. Hope you hope it don't come out. But, so let's start. Now, how to form the equation? What's the equation? Y equals to what? K over X cubed. Correct. Now, if I give you X and Y numbers, easy to do. But if I don't give you, how do you do it? First, you use O set of value. I'll show you. So, O set of value, did they give anything?
No.
Didn't, right? So, it's still Y equals to K over X cubed. Now, the key word here is make K subject. Is it easy? K equals to Y X cubed. This is equation 1. 2. This is equation 1. No space, I don't write it. Now, new value. Now, new value, every time there's a pattern, they will tell you X increase, Y decrease, or X decrease, Y decrease. What did you say? Y now, X now become 40%. Do you know how many X is there? 1.4 X. Can follow? Okay, so now this is equation 3. Now I want you to put this. I want you to put 2 and 3 in 1. Y still 1. Equal. K become yx cubed over x become 1.4x holding cube. Holding. Because x cubed. The x now becomes 1.4x. So now the holding cube. Now, if you don't understand it later, I just want you to forget. Or come to me after school. But if you can accept this method, then it be, you can do this question. If you cannot accept, then never mind. 2 marks. X cube, can I answer?
Yeah.
Can, but this 1.4 will cube it, right? So can you press 1.4
cube?
2.744. 1 over 2.744?
125
over 343y. Y. And then the cube cancel. Can you follow this? Do you know how I get this number?
I illustrate. This number is actually 1 over 1.4 cubed.
1 over 1.4 cubed. If I tell you the correct now, I just write down what I just said. So it's correct.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, how do I read this number? This y here is new or old?
New.
This is a new.
So this is a new y. What about this y?
This is the old y. So it's like this new y is 125 parts out of 243 parts of the OI. How do I find the decrease? How do I find the percentage decrease? Take the difference over original times 100%. Can follow? So I write out the finishing statement. So in order to find out the percentage increase, I will take Y new minus YO divided by YO times 100%. Y new is actually 125 over 343. So this is 125 over 343 of YO minus 1. Is it difficult to? Now, with this number, I actually press calculator. 125 over 343 minus 1.
Not 1 minus.
Not 1 minus, huh? Not 1 minus. Is this fraction minus 1. What's the answer? That is
53 minus 6.
Huh? That means he's telling us please off the aircon because I'm sleeping. What's the answer?
Ah. 63.6.
Negative 63.6%, is it?
Yeah.
So that's the answer. Get the idea? So I summarize. So every time you see this kind of question where they didn't tell you anything, number one, just make clear the subject. Number two, write down a new condition. Put these two conditions into the original equation. Then try and cancel the x, and you will see a fraction. If this is 2, means the new y is 2 times the old y, something like that. Then after that, they will ask you to find. But all these, so many steps, just for the 2 marks. So if you see, not sure, you see, put it to the last question. Okay?
Okay, next.
9. Now, question 9, let's discuss. If I am writing faster than you and you can't catch, later go back to the video, scroll to that part, watch, and then forget about it. Yeah, this video. Okay, so you just listen. Just listen. Because 2 minutes are going through the whole thing. Go to sleep, do two other things. E-math teacher very disappointed.
Okay, is Rina correct?
Wrong.
Why?
Because it's $2 short.
$2 short?
$2.20.
Lesser?
Yeah.
Everyone got this answer?
Yes, okay.
How to show your weight correctly? I must do. Okay, so let's take it. I think I tell you this story before. So Egan bring his friend to a restaurant, right? And eat a $10. $12, easier. Now, which one should I charge first?
Service charge.
So service charge, how much?
10%.
How much is that? 1.2. Altogether, how much? 13.2. I add. Then after that, what do I do? 7% GST. How much is it? Just let me count. 0.924. And then this is my total bill. I plus. This is my total bill. Understand? Okay. So I need to work backwards. So let's try. This is 435.73. This is how many percent? 100. Any other number? 107. This is wrong. The correct answer is 107. Not 117. If you put 117, you are telling me $12 straight away times 70%. Is it the same? Is it more or less? Correct. This is GST and service charge. You see, now, this is how much? Can you add for me, Aiden's bill? 13.2 plus 0.924. What's the number? 14.124. Now, if you take $12 straight away times 1.17, how much is it? 14.04. Do you see this is lesser than this? The reason is because it's not like that. It's not just times 70%. It's times 10, then times 7. Clear? Okay, let's go. Now, so the correct way is you do step by step. First, this is 107%. How many percent you want to find? 100%. How much is it? Count. 1,047.224. Now draw a double line, or draw a line. This 407.224 is how many percent again? 110%. Do you know why is there like that? Because this amount is with service charge. I write down. This amount is with the 10% included. If I want to calculate, exclude this 10%, what I do is I make this 110%. Then I calculate the 100%. How much is it? 370, exact. 0.203. So then this is the original bill. Oh yeah, then you are correct lah. It's not $2.20, it's $2.20, sorry. $2.22, something like that. So this is the original view, but they say the original view is just so too strong. Understand? Now, if you present like that, will you get the mark? No. Why? No? No statement. So how should you write the statement? This is...
As it is $2.20.
Oh, I mean that statement. Okay.
What I mean is, maybe you want to explain what does this number mean.
Maybe
you want to explain what does this number mean. Now, even if you box up, write that original view, it's better than you don't write anything. Clear?
So, you can write like this, is the view with 10% service charge.
Okay, there's some statement to explain what is this number. Some statement to explain what is this number, understand? Then, to finish it off,
then you write, Vina is wrong as the view is 370.203 instead of 372.42, something like that.
Or you can tell me the difference up to you. Or you can tell me the original is that instead of this. And that's 3 marks. So the ability to write this is 2 marks. The ability to finish your sentence, telling me it's wrong because there's a difference in 1 mark. Can you switch another way? Can you do the 110? Oh, good. Kevin got one method. Can you do the other way? You use this amount, 372.42. Then you times 10%. Then after that amount you times 7%. Then you see whether this is equal to 435.73. Can you do this method?
Yes,
legit. This is correct. You understand?
Correct. We now state that this is the was the 100% view. So what you do is
you take this view, you times 10%. You add 8, wait, 2 versus 3. Or is it 3?
Yeah,
you
can do
both. Oh, you have to do both.
Yeah.
2 4 or 1.
Can
you?
Okay.
Yeah, then we. Now, so can you take this times 10% get the amount, then times 7% get the amount, then you say, oh, this is not equal. Therefore, this is wrong. You can. 4 marks, 3 marks.
You can.
So there are 2 ways to do it. Okay, next.
Question 10. I got to be faster because some of you are falling asleep. 10A is okay? No. Describe set A. Is it written in the answer sheet?
Yes.
No. They want to describe in words.
Then
I go and explain. It was what? It has 2, 3, 5, 7. Who are all of this? Prime number. Not difficult. Next one. B. Using setter, using builder notation. So you have, you have to write equal bracket, x is to x is a prime number. This is set notation.
So let me explain. This is set builder notation. It's just telling you, instead of describing the words, you're right in terms of this symbol. Right, yes?
Yeah.
Or? Yeah, okay. B?
B is okay? N? Okay, now, I am not sure, so what I'll do is I will draw a box. I will draw 2 circles, and then I label 1, 2. 3, 4. A is 2 and 3. B complement is 1 and 2. So the overlap is 2. The overlap was here. I want to count the number of elements.
It has
how many elements?
Sure.
It has 3. 3 was inside. 5 was inside, 7 was inside.
So what's the answer?
Yeah.
So n
of this is equal to 3. So that's the answer. Next, C. C is okay? Oh, C is, what does this mean?
Subset,
right?
CCB.
Help me. Is it like that? Or is it like that? One or two?
Then what's wrong?
Oh, you don't know how it looks like. So your answer is like that. In red is my answer.
Can you tell me the element inside?
Huh? 4 and 6
ah.
Okay. But if, can you write a number inside? If I challenge you to write a number inside, what element will you suggest that C contains?
8, 9, 10.
8, 9, 10? Cannot. B seems to be what?
Even number.
Even number, right? Or equal or 2. So maybe not 9. But you can also draw an thing and then house the 4 and 6 inside, that's fine. So anything that is inside, you get one mark. Let's go. Up to you. Oh yeah, cannot put 8. Then this is wrong. Sorry. 8 is wrong because the universal set says that it cannot be more than 8. It must be less than 8. Okay? Next, 11. Everyone must listen about 11 because it's so tricky. Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, see, I want to go. Okay. Now, I have 5 items here. I cannot do grouping. I cannot do 2 by 2. If I have 4, I have 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe I can try 2 by 2. But if you have 5, or when you see this structure, I want you to recognize A square, AB, B square. You know this is a quadratic equation. So you have to factorize the quadratic. You have to recognize. So the answer will be, first, I write 4A square minus 12AB plus 9B square plus 4A minus 6B. These three, I want you to group first. Now, everyone, tell me the answer. These three group into the quadratic. You know how to do this in cross factorization? So what will happen is this will be 4a square, this will be 9b square, this will be aa, bb, this will be ab, ab, this will be negative 12ab. Can I understand? So what number do I put here? I try. I'm not sure. 3, 3. Multiply up, this will be 6. Multiply down, this will be 6. How to make it is a plus. Plus. Wrong line. Ryan? I let you hold the report, You will off it yourself. Aircon not too cold. Not cold, huh? That one's sticky.
I know.
You okay? You got this problem also? Oh, you want to listen? Guys, so
yeah.
Okay. I'm not comfortable. I'm worried. Okay, with this part can understand. So can I write the answer back to the bracket? So then the bracket will look like 2a minus 3b, 2a minus 3b. You want to write square, fine. The second one, how do I continue?
About two.
What's the answer? 2 bracket 2a minus 3b. So now I look at it, it looks like I have two trays.
I have 2a minus 3b. So I go ahead and take out 2a minus 3b. Yes, guess what you are saying? Oh, is it Dixon? Huh? Wait, wait, why? Yeah, what's the answer? 2a minus 3b plus 2. Can you follow? So I take out this first tray, left 2a minus 3b. Second tray, left 2, so plus 2. Not obvious. This 2a minus 3b is here. This 2, this plus 2, this plus 2. And next.
11c.
Alright, go. 12. Okay, 12. Alright, question 12c. Mass. Now, if I look at mass, simple. If this is similar, then what can you say about volume? Now, there's a new episode, right? If it's same material or same density, M1 over M2 is equals to V1 over V2 is equals to L1 over L2 Q. Oh, but the density is different, right? One mark. Wow.
One is over 25.
How? So now the case is different density. Let's try and understand the formula. What's the formula here? Density equals to?
M over L.
Now, since it's different density, everything here is out. Now, I look at this. What is the only thing I know I need to make that into the subject? Is it D, M or B? This is B1 over B2. Some of you are not looking up. This is V1 over V2. This is D equals to M over V. What should I make the subject? V, right? So V equals to?
M over D.
So if I put this, let's call some equation. This is equation 2, this is equation 1. If I put equation 2 in 1, how will it look like? Again, I put equation 2, this one, into here. V1 will means it is M1 over D1. Over?
M over
25. M2 over D2. Equal? L1 over L2 cube. Who don't understand this? All understand. Same density means the D and D will cancel. But now, different density. Let's try and not use 1, 2. Let's try and use gold and paper. So 1 is gold. This is paper. Do I have some formula? What is? Because 1 and 2, I'm not sure. Y'all use paper on top or paper below? For the L1, okay. L1 over L2 cube, you have the number? Have. What's the number you use? Maybe you give me the length.
4 5.
No, they have the volume as well. 4 is to 5. This 4 is paper or?
Gold.
This is? Gold. This is paper. Really? The volume of gold is 1280. The volume of paper is... Oh, correct.
So this is density of gold. This is density of paper. Can you construct an equation? Density of gold equal to density of paper. Which one is 25 or which one? Gold is 25 of... Okay. Whoa. So this is gold. Am I confusing you? This is just 1 mark. Oh my god. Is the 405 correct? Yeah. Correct, huh? Okay. So what I will do is I will put this 25 into the gold. So then you can cancel the density of paper. So you have mass of gold divided by 25 over mass of paper. The smaller mass to the bigger mass. Oh. So this is 4:5. Now I want to break this down. This is a divide. So this one will be m of gold over 25 times. No, divide by. Yeah, so much for 1 mark. No, they only want the smaller mass to the bigger mass. So the answer is 4 over 5 times 25. What's the answer?
I multiply the whole point, then I don't know what I find.
20 over 1.
No, I find 5 over 24.
Is the answer 20 over 1?
No.
5 over 24.
What?
I find 5 over 24.
What? Why wrong? This 4 over 5 is the length or the volume?
The length.
Oh, then you didn't. Oh, then I didn't cube. So this one will be 64 over 125 times 25. 64 over 5. Ah, correct. Oh, but they want mass of smaller, right? This is gold, this is paper. So mass of paper over mass of gold will be 5 over 64. But for this for 1 mark. Yeah. My thinking is slow, but you have the faster you are doing it. Or you don't know what I'm doing already.
One three step.
1 mark 3 step is fair.
Didn't.
You half step.